number one here in Tampa. Islanders with a 2-1 lead over the Lightning after 40 minutes of play. The Force is with the New York Islanders as the Buffalo Sabres visit from a galaxy far, far away. Just update for a matinee matchup at the Barn on Saturday, December 14th. The first 10,000 fans in attendance will take home an exclusive New York Islanders Star Wars scarf. Don't miss Star Wars Day. Grab your seats at NewYorkIslanders.com/TV. We are very excited to have a special guest. Claire Arbour is joining us now. Of course, legendary Islanders head coach Al Arbour, coaching for many, many years for this team. And even when Ross Johnston was just here, he wanted to come over and shake your hand because you guys as a family were such a big part of this Islanders organization. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, well, thank you for asking me.
I saw you ice side up at the glass watching the game, cheering for the Islanders in this game.
Oh, I am.
I want to go back to the 80s because we hear lots of stories from the former players about that first cup. And I was just wondering, where were you and what were you thinking when they picked up that first Stanley Cup championship?
Well, the first cup we won it right there at the Coliseum. And I was so relieved that it was finally over. You know, the buildup was really getting, you know, it's so stretched out now. It's like weeks and weeks of the high-pressure hockey. So I just sat there and let the tears come out and said, thank God I could not put myself together for another game.
I think a lot of the players have had the same mentality there.
Yes.
Why do you feel like your husband was so successful as a coach?
Well, his quality was that he truly cared for the players. He just really motivated them and made them reach beyond what they thought they could do. And it was a special feeling on the whole team because they just played for each other. And that was his secret, to make them care for one another.
I know you watch a lot of Islanders games.
Yes, I do.
We were chatting about that. She wouldn't share her favorite player because you said you like all the players.
I like them all. I think they're all very, very interesting individuals.
But you do like Barry Trotz. What is it about him that you like?
Oh, I like the way he handles the team. He's a very, quiet man. He instills confidence in his players. Seems to be a very understanding man of his players, so I love his demeanor. I love the way he's handling things.
Your husband, a legend for Islanders fans, and I think the fans at home also understand that being a family is a big part of these players' successes. What was it like when you were a player's wife and a coach's wife in the league and kind of that dynamic around the family?
Well, his playing career finished in St. Louis, and we actually, in St. Louis, the first place that they had a wives' room where we could gather, and so we were all close and just had lunch together and dinner together, and it was like a great big family. And what was it like? We were all friends and everything. But I became a coach overnight, and all of a sudden, in that wives' room, I didn't know if I should sit with the players' wives or the coaches, the management place. So it was a little confusing at times.
Well, you made quite the transition, and we really appreciate you coming and chatting with us. And of course, your support for the team. I know you guys watch nightly down here in Florida, so.
I have the hockey package, and I don't miss a game.
Okay, great. You're our good luck charm. Thanks so much, Claire. All right, we're heading to break here in Tampa. When we come back, Butch and Brendan taking a look at the highlights from the second period action.